Hello student, so after completing the problem number 2 on transcendental function, I am going to start with the problem 3rd on transcendental function. So here we'll learn how to find out the nth derivative by using the concept of successive differentiation. So let's start. So guys, here we have function as 2 to the power x sine square x cos cube x, and for this we have to find out the nth derivative. Now the question is how to get it. So first thing is, if you observe, this function is transcendental function, and if we see the formula, then we do not have any formula for this 2 to the power x sine square x into cos cube x. But guys, if we do a few adjustments, then I'm sure that we can find out the nth derivative of this function. So for that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna convert that 2 to the power x into the exponential function, that e to the power ax form. So for that, what we'll do is, here I'll say this 2 to the power x as e to the power log of 2 to the power x. What I did is, here I've taken log and base as e, so this gets cancelled and we again get 2 to the power x. So guys, this is, I'll rewrite as e to the power x into log of 2. So here I've applied a property of logarithm, that is log of a to the power b is b log a. Now guys, by doing this, here we got this in a form of e to the power ax, where a is log 2. Now if I substitute it over here, I will get y as e to the power log of 2 into x into sine square x into cos cube x. So guys, here I have converted this question in the previous numerical. So if you watch my previous video, there we have solved the similar type of question. So guys, I am gonna follow the same method which I did in the previous sum. So first of all, I'll find out the value for sine square x and cos cube x by using the trigonometric formula. So here we'll say y equal to e to the power log of 2 into x, and for sine square x, we all know that it is 1 minus cos of 2x upon 2. So this formula will apply here. Now for cos cube x, we will use a formula of cos 3x. So guys, here I'll show you the formula. So formula for cos of 3x is 4 cos cube x minus 3 cos of x. Now since I want the value of cos cube x, what I'll do here is I will take this negative 3 cos x on the left hand side, that will become plus 3 cos x. So I will get cos of 3x plus 3 cos of x equal to 4 cos cube x. Now, as I want cos cube x, I'll transfer this 4 to the other side, that will go and divide here. So it means we'll get value of cos cube x as cos 3x plus 3 cos x whole upon 4, and I'll substitute that value over here. So we'll write here. Now guys, here if you see, then we'll say y as 2 into 4, 8. So 1 upon 8 outside. Then e to the power log of 2 into x, and then we'll multiply these two brackets. So if I multiply the second bracket by 1, we will get cos of 3x plus 3 cos of x, and then we will get negative cos of 2x into cos of 3x. Next, if I multiply this with this, we will get negative 3 cos of 2x into cos of x. Now guys, I'll take this e to the power log 2x inside and I'll multiply each and every term. But before that, if you observe the third and fourth term, here we can apply the formula of defactorization. So let's apply it. So guys, here we'll get value of y as 1 upon 8 e to the power log of 2 into x in bracket. So first two terms as it is. Now here cos 2x into cos 3x. Here I'll apply the formula of cos A into cos B. So by doing that, we will get half in bracket cos of A plus B, that is 5x, plus cos of A minus B, that is minus x. Next, here we have minus 3, which will come outside, and again I'll apply the formula of cos A into cos B. So minus 3 outside upon 2, because we will get 1 by 2, and in bracket cos of 3x plus cos of x. So here I have applied the formula of cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. Now guys, let's take similar terms together. So we will get y as 1 upon 8 e to the power log of 2 into x in bracket. Now let's observe the term. So here I have cos of 3x, and again we have one more term here, that is negative 3 by 2 cos of 3x. So guys, I'll write it as 1 minus 3 by 2, which are the coefficient, and cos of 3x is common in these two terms. Similarly, if you observe the cos x term, then I'll take cos x common, so 3 will be in bracket. From here we will get cos of x, because cos of minus theta is cos theta. So this positive cos of x will become negative due to this sign which is outside the bracket. So that will become minus 1. And we have just two terms. So bracket close and cos x is common. Next, we have cos of 5x term. So that is minus 1 upon 2 cos of 5x. Now guys, here we have one more term of cos of x. Here you can see that I have taken this 3 for cos x, then I have taken minus 1 from here, and still we have one more term, which is minus 3 by 2. So that minus 3 by 2 will also come here. So I'll write down that value directly in the next step. So y equal to 1 by 8 e to the power log of 2 into x in bracket. Now this will become minus 1 upon 2 cos of 3x. Here we have 3 minus 1, and again we have minus 3 by 2. So 3 minus 1 is 2, and 2 minus 3 by 2 is plus 1 by 2 into cos of x. And then we have minus 1 by 2 cos of 5x. Now guys, from these three terms, we can take half outside or negative half outside. So we will get y as negative 1 upon 16 e to the power log of 2 into x in bracket. So from here, we will get only cos of 3x. From here, minus cos of x. And from here, plus cos of 5x. And now guys, to take or to get the nth derivative, we will multiply each term in the bracket by e to the power log 2 into x. So y is negative 1 by 16 in bracket. So this I'll get if I multiply this first term with e to the power log 2 into x. Now I'll multiply to second and third term. So we'll get So guys, this is the value of y. Now we'll find out the nth derivative of this. So we have a formula for that. So guys, here I'm going to use the formula of e to the power ax into cos bx. So I'll say by using the formula of nth derivative, we will get minus 1 by 16 in bracket. Here we will get r1 raised to n. Now value of r1 we will define here, which is under root a square plus b square, where a is log 2 and b is 3. Next, e to the power log of 2 into x into cos of 3x plus n phi 1. And guys, phi 1 is tan inverse b by a. So if I write that here, so here I'll say where r1 is equal to under root a square plus b square. So that will become log of 2 the whole square plus b square, that is 3 square is 9. And at the same time, we will get phi 1 as tan inverse of b by a, that is 3 by log of 2. Now guys, similarly, we'll get nth derivative for remaining two terms. So minus n as it is here, r2 raised to n e to the power log of 2 into x. This will give us cos of x plus n phi 2. Next sign is plus. Here we will get e to the power. So before that, we will get r3 raised to n. So I'll write down this term first. So log 2 into x into r3 raised to n. So it doesn't matter if I write e to the power term first and then r3 term. And then we will get cos of 5x plus n phi 3. Now by similarly, we'll define the values of r2, r3 and phi 2, phi 3. So for r2, let's come here. So r2 will be under root log of 2 the whole square plus 1, and phi 2 would be tan inverse of 1 upon log of 2. And the last value, that is value of r3 and phi 3. So r3 is under root log of 2 the whole square plus 25, because here value of b is 5, and phi 3 would be tan inverse of 5 upon log of 2. So guys, this is the answer. If we can write one more step by minimizing this e to the power log 2 into x as 2 raised to x, because we got this term from here. So e to the power log 2 into x is nothing but 2 raised to x. So in the final answer, you can substitute this value. Here I'll underline this value as 2 raised to x, this value as 2 raised to x, and this value as 2 raised to x. Remaining other terms will remain same. And guys, that is the nth derivative of given function. So I'm sure you understood about the nth derivative of given transcendental function. So guys, keep watching the videos, because in the next video, I'm gonna cover few more numericals on successive differentiation. Thank you very much.